Welcome to Chapter 5, the Lipids, Fats, Oils, Phospholipids, and Steroids. How to Consume Less Fat by Professor Tammy. Learning objectives. 1. Describe the role of fats in chronic diseases and how our bodies are affected. 2. Describe ways to reduce solid fats in an average diet.
Defensive dining. You should read the ingredients, the food facts, the food labels. In the grocery stores, you know, just watch out for margarine, hydrogenated fats. They're just as bad as saturated fats. You want to choose more unsaturated oils. When you need fat replacers and artificial fats, you want to know more about, you know, how to cook them. Are they going to taste different, or the texture of the food will be different, the smell of the food will be different? And you can also revamp recipes. Like if it calls for butter, you can put olive oil instead. Fast food choices. When you go to eat out, especially when the food's quick, like French fries, burgers, chicken nuggets, you want to, understand what you're eating. You can especially if it's a franchise, you can always, Google the calories, the saturated fat and stuff. Change your habits, suggest changes. Always do small step changes because it reaps big rewards. Because if you try to have your change too quickly, then you're going to more likely fail and feel like, you know what? I failed. I did not succeed the first try. I quit. You want to take step by step, because if you make small change, you're like, yes, I did it. I can go to the next step. So when you take your steps one by one, eventually you're going to see the results at the end. Versus if you try to do everything at once, you're like, I'm just overwhelmed. You might decide to just quit. Replacing saturated fat with unsaturated fat helps reduce risk of heart disease. Regular consumption of omega-3 fatty acids suppresses inflammation, which may protect against some cancers. Fish oil supplements are available but not recommended for routine supplementation due to side effects. The type of fat consumed is important. Intake of saturated and trans fatty acids should be minimized as much as possible. We typically get enough linoleic acid in our diets from salad dressings, vegetable oils, margarines, and mayos. To ensure an adequate amount of omega-3 fatty acids, we need to consume more dark green leafy vegetables, walnuts, flaxseeds, and fish or fish oils. The DASH diet plan. You can look at the food groups and also look at the daily servings to see how much you should be having each day from each food group just to improve your physical health. Cutting fat cuts kilocalories in saturated fat. So when you look at it, remember we mentioned about the milk. Okay, let's talk about the potatoes. When you have a baked potato with butter and sour cream, you know, you're going to have 14 grams of fat, 10 grams of saturated fat, and 350 calories. Versus if you didn't have the butter or the sour cream, you have 200 kilocalories, which is 150 less. As far as fat, you have 13 less, and for saturated fat, you have about 10 less. And you can also look at these. These have already calculated for you. And for pork chop. I know some of us really like the, you know, pork chop, the fat. That's once in a while. You shouldn't have it every day. When you cut off the fat around the pork chop and it's just lean meat or meat, you're not consuming 110 kilocalories. You're not consuming the 10 grams of fat and also the 4 grams of saturated fat. So you have less calories, less fat, and saturated fat. Two meals compared. So when you look at it, this is a saturated fat meal and this is the unsaturated fat meal. So in order to lower saturated fat and raise monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fat, you need to change how you eat. So when you look at the food here, it's a total of 600 calories, just like this. And when you compare the fat, the saturated fat meal has far less unsaturated fat, much more saturated fat, and the total fat is just slightly more. But the difference they're really talking about is having more unsaturated fat versus saturated fat, because think about when saturated fat is hard in room temperature, what happens when you're consuming it? Versus the unsaturated fat is liquid in room temperature. And when you consume it, think about that. The hardening, the hard fat versus the soft fat that, or the liquid fat that you are consuming in your body.
See you soon. And remember to read the book.